So Robert, in about a month from now, month and a half, Margarito will be here.
Yeah, well, he's probably December 3rd, so 2 months.
How would training camp go for him, for Cotto?
Like it was before, fun. Fun and hard. He trains hard.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Do you guys like something new today? Someone's talking about relief from stress. Is that something that affects everyone? Are you retorting me?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hello.
All right, and this one's also talking about the 5 secrets of contentment. And it goes into what the Bible says about being content. Would you guys read it if I left it with you guys? No.
Is it about boxing?
Oh, I don't know. There's other interesting articles. So.
No, but thank you.
All right.
Straight out I.
Nope, I won't read it.
Stress. She was stressing out talking to me.
Yeah, she was. Margarito's training camp will be fun. You know, the two that we've had, they've always been fun. He likes it. He enjoys it. And that's what the way it should be.
He once fought Sergio Martinez when they won 147. He beat him. Would there ever be a rematch, him and Sergio?
Possible also. You know, Margarito beats Cotto, and then hell yeah, those are the chances of a rematch happening. It would be
a pay-per-view. How crazy would that be?
You know, that's what Martinez needs right now. You know, he needs to fight somebody in that caliber for him to be pay-per-view, because he himself cannot headline a pay-per-view card, you know, by fighting these Russian guys that he's been fighting, or whoever, he, you know.
Nice fighting a British guy, Darren Barker.
British, Russians, whatever, you know, those guys that he's been fighting, you know, he can't headline pay-per-view. He's good enough to do it, but not himself. You know, he needs a big name again, you know, like a Margarito or a Cotto, a Mayweather, if something like that ever happened. Himself, he just can't do it.
Except maybe one or two fighters. Everybody needs a big name in there.
Yeah, they all need a big name. And that's big pay-per-view right there for Martinez and Margarito. Margarito's been there before.
Can Margarito beat him now? It's a different Sergio.
Not an easy fight. Sergio's a hell of a fighter, but Margarito's style is a style that could beat the Martinez style, that could beat, you know, Cotto style. You know, his style is just like Brandon's. You know, you pressure and, you know, you don't give up. You might lose the first half of the fight, but then you still got 6 more rounds, and, you know, it's been like that with Margarito. It's been like that with Brandon, and he's been very successful. Brandon's winning right now, and Brandon's kicking ass. So of course it's possible.
Of course. Listo, Carlos.
How's it going? Good. Where is everybody? You ran by yourself?
You beat everybody, that's why.
You beat everybody?
Sorry for
that. Oh, he's being honest.
He don't lie, he's honest.
I would have said, yeah, I beat everybody.
He started before over, see?
He's honest. He's not lying.
But that's cool, but Margarito is one of those fighters people either love or don't love.
Yeah. Well, everybody loved him until that, you know, the hand wrap situation, you know, because, you know, it was pretty bad, you know, but you know, when it comes to really think things over, you know, look at, you know, nobody says anything, you know, mostly use steroids for a few of his fights, you know, there's been other fighters, you know, that do pretty stuff like that, and, you know, people forget, you know. People just can't forget this. It was just a mistake that his trainer made. You know, Margarito, nobody can prove that Margarito knew about it. So why not give him another chance? You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Why not give him another chance?